So guys, we are back with another edition of Fastened Up in Star Live. We have this series running for the last 2 months. We have had some wonderful personalities, sports people joining us from a variety of sports. Today we have another cricketing personalities. The two brothers, Baba Inderjeet and Baba Aparjeet. It'll be a fun session with them. We had Ankit Bhavne join us on Monday. It's been a fabulous time talking to all these people. So we are here again, and on Friday we have a session with Nisha Millet, who is Olympic swimmer, 2004 Sydney, or 2000 rather Sydney. So let me see if Upper has joined. We'll get both of them in a while. So trying to get the Baba brothers in. So let me see if they are joining in. Upper to the handle, and we will have Upper and Inder joining us today. Today is a Wednesday evening on Fastened Up Live. It's been a great 2 months talking to different people. Hello, Upper and Inder.
Hi, how are you? Hi, Vijay.
How are you?
Great. So I have difficulties identifying who is who. I'm sure that will be the story for a lot of us. So can I guess first before I...
Yes.
So is a person who is wearing the white, is that Inderjeet?
Yes, that's right.
Correct, Vijay.
So my guesses are not bad. So before we join in, guys, let me first introduce you both to the viewers. So we have got two of the mainstay cricketers from the Tamil Nadu cricket team, Baba Inderjeet and Aparjeet. For those of you who don't know them, they have been around the Tamil Nadu team for almost 6-7 years now, I would believe, more than that. Both top order batsmen from twins, in fact, having been playing a lot of cricket together. Inderjeet obviously has also captained Tamil Nadu. I mean, Upper, have you captained? I'm sorry, my knowledge
yes,
may
yes.
not be right.
Few games, is it?
So both of you have captained, and in fact, Upper has also represented India in the under-19 2012 famous triumph, where we had the class of 2012 winning the under-19 World Cup. So welcome to you both, Inder and Upper.
Thank you
for having us, Vijay. Great. So let's have a free flow. What are you guys doing during the COVID time?
Nothing special, actually. We're just training at home and then doing some household chores and trying to learn something new and something useful. Mostly indoors only. We don't go out much.
So what is the thing that you're trying to learn new? I see some of your Insta stories. So
yeah, I've been trying to cook of late. So that's what I've been trying now. Apart from that, nothing much actually.
So Upper, you also are a good cook?
Not actually.
No.
I taste his food and give some feedback to him.
That's right. So before we start asking you questions, I also wanted to ask you one more thing. Who is the more talkative of you both?
That's very quiet, yeah, actually, yeah, but quiet. It's very difficult to answer that question. Maybe Upper, a little bit, I don't know. Both of us are really...
I had a hunch that Upper might be a little bit more talkative. It was a hunch. So let us get going, guys. It's very unique to see two top-order cricketers playing at the same time from the same family, for a state like Tamil Nadu, which is also one of the top states in the country as far as cricketing is concerned. So how did it all start? When did you get into cricket?
So you were very young when we started cricket. We were about 4.5, 5. And we joined a coaching camp nearby. And then it started gradually. We started playing tennis ball in the beginning. And then we moved to cricket ball. And then gradually we started playing age cricket, like under 10, under 12. And then from there, we started playing for the state. I think Inder represented Tamil Nadu when he was 10, I think.
9 years old.
9 years. So it started from there. Then Upper made his debut at the age of 17 for the Tamil Nadu Ranji Trophy. And I was 19 when I made my debut.
Fantastic. So was there always a little bit of a competition inside the family? I mean, not in a bad way, but in a good way, you know, to take you along?
No, it's not been like that. A lot of people ask us that question because us being twins, it's people bound to compare us and they ask this question, but we've never felt that way. There's never been a rivalry sort of thing in between us. We've always supported each other. We've always complimented each other. We try and help each other out.
So amongst you, who is probably the bigger brother kind of thing? Who supports or who shades the other person?
Inder is he's 26 minutes older than me. So, and he's captained right through his career. So he has been the one who makes decisions at home. And he's slightly more authoritative.
That's a very sweet way of putting it. Thanks, Apar, for sharing that insight with me. So one quick question that I want, I mean, we have a lot of viewers. So if any one of you have questions, please put it down and I'm sure they will be answering that. So I also would see a lot of cricketers joining in. So we'll always say hello to them. So that is great. So one trivia about you people, both of you, is that you are both batsmen. But I think Inder does the leg break, Apar does the off break. How did that happen? Why didn't you choose the same spinning option?
No, from the beginning itself, I was bowling leg spin. I was actually bowling medium pace. I was a fast bowler, but I was not really fast. But at the age of 13, 14, I realized that I couldn't bowl quick. So I thought, okay, off spin would be a better option than medium pace because I didn't have the height also at that point. So I was very slow. So I thought maybe spin would work.
Mm-hmm. So let's take a quick question from Kirtana. She's asking, who is your inspiration? I mean, I think that spelling is probably incorrect. So it will be inspiration. What is your inspiration? Who is your inspiration?
Well, there have been a lot of people growing up. Sachin Tendulkar was one. And nowadays, we both are a big fan of MS Dhoni. So there are a lot of cricketers we look up to. Right from Tendulkar to Rahul Dravid to a lot of cricketers. So it's very hard to just name one.
Okay. So Akhil Srinath says he loves your hairband. So that is great. When you guys were growing up, to be honest, 2012, a lot of us watched cricket. 2012, I know Upper played a great, memorable tournament. So how did it feel for Inder? Because Inder was also 19. He was also eligible for the under-19 squad. So how did you take those disappointment at that stage, Inder?
Initially, it was a bit hard because it was new for me. We used to playing for the same team right from age category to under-19 to everything, state matches. We used to play together. So that was the first time for me. Both of us being in a different team and me not being selected was a bit different. Initially, it was a bit difficult. But it taught me a lot of things. From there, mentally, it helped me a lot. So we understood that it is not easy for us to be playing for the same team every time. Just because we are twins, we cannot play this for the same team at the same time. It is not that easy. So that taught me a lot of things.
Right. So on the same level, Apar, you tasted a lot of success during that 2012 period. You were a rock star at that point of time. To put it bluntly, right? I mean, you are a winner. I mean, not you. I mean, and the team itself, with Unmukh Chand and Prashant Chopra, you and. But then graduating from that class of 2012 to the senior team has been not so easy, right? Looking back, how was that journey? I mean, what would you want to tell people who are now playing under 19?
I think definitely it was a memorable period for all of us, not only me, to go out there, not only play the tournament for the country, to win a tournament that way in Australia was a difficult thing, challenging thing, but it was a memorable time, but we didn't understand a lot of things at that point. We were very young. I was not too matured also at that point, but I learned a lot of things coming back from that tournament. A lot of us got a lot more opportunities when we came back. I was picked for the Challenger Trophy. That was my first List A game. So a lot of good things happened. At the same time, I learned a lot. It was everything happened very quickly for me. And that was a great experience for me at a challenging time.
But very, very diplomatically put. But I just wanted to get one more insight, Upper, because a lot of people who play for under 19, I mean, it's a long process to the senior team, right? And if you take your batch of 2012, I was just looking at the statistics. Maybe one person has played for the test team. I mean, is that correct?
Hanuma? Bihari has played, yes.
Yeah, so that too recently, after a lot of efforts, he has graduated, right, to the Indian team. So is there a big change in terms of how you perform at under 19 and then you come to the Indian national side? I mean, is there a big change?
See, definitely domestic cricket is totally different from under 19 cricket. It's a big transition because after playing under 19, when you come back, you have to play the same level of, or if not more, and perform consistently, because performing in under 19 is one thing. After that, you have to back your performances in domestic cricket as well. That too for a season or two. I think Vihari did that really well, and he waited and he got his opportunity. So I think all of us, if we put in that effort and perform for a season or two, if we get those big scores, I think we will also come there soon.
I'm trying to also say that Inder probably didn't make it in 2012, but he has had a great last 4-5 years where he has really worked hard and really gone on to do well. So I think there are. I'm sure both of you would have been supporting each other very well during this period. Inder, how was your transition from that under 19 to the Ranji Trophy and, you know, playing even for India A?
As I said, when I missed out on the under 19 thing, it made me even more tougher. So, and I wanted to play for the state so badly. Upper made his debut at 17, I was 19. So those 2 years helped me a lot, actually. So when I came into the scene, so I was able to handle the situations even more better. And I was slightly more matured when I made my debut. So I was able to understand things. In those 2 years, we played a lot of league cricket here, went out and played a lot of matches. So that taught me a lot of things, actually.
So there's a question from Yamu Insta. She's asking, he or she is asking, describe something about the TN Tamil Nadu dressing room. How does it feel to be with the T team? Give us a little bit about how the Tamil Nadu dressing room is.
It's always fun, actually. When you're traveling with the team, when you're inside the dressing room, it's always fun. And develop a lot of relationships over the years. There's a lot of cricketers, a lot of friends in the dressing room. It's always light in the dressing room.
It's what I've figured out in the first 10 minutes of my conversation is that it's very difficult to take things out of you. You have very diplomatic, nice answers, which is interesting, which is good. TNPL should have happened right now, right? TNPL. Yeah. So do you miss the TNPL?
Definitely. It was supposed to happen. Actually, today is June 10th, I think.
Yeah,
Today was supposed to be the first game of TNPL, but unfortunately, because of the situation all over the world, I think it has been postponed. Hopefully, we'll get to play soon, but you never know. We'll have to wait and see.
Without the spectators, is it?
Yeah, I think there will be a lot
with
of
the current situation.
If it happens, then with the current situation, without the spectators, most probably.
Right. So, both of you, let us talk about a little bit about the fitness side of things. I mean, I'm sure that both of you would be putting in a lot of effort on fitness, on maintaining your fitness, etc. So, where do you work out? What do you do? Can you describe it in a nutshell? How many hours do you put for strength training, conditioning, etc.?
I think right now we are putting in a lot of effort. The only thing we do at home is training, and we were training at Primal Patterns also. And I am sure, you know, Basu sir, we train under him. So we train almost every day, and we are putting in a lot of effort these days, actually.
Mm-hmm. So I think your friend Mohit Sharma.
Sorry?
I think your friend Mohit Sharma is confused who is Upper and who is Inder. So so you can say hello to him.
Mohit, white t-shirt is Inder and this is Upper. Hi, Mohit.
Great. So you talked about fitness, right? And I think in the last 5-6 years, there has been a big change in the way fitness has been seen by the Indian cricket community, with everyone putting in that kind of hours. So how many hours of fitness do do you put in a week?
See, if we, see when we are traveling, the time reduces a bit because it is not easy. It is just a maintenance phase. But when we are in Chennai, when we are at home, then we train a lot. I think 4 days out of in a week we train. And if you're not playing, like if we have an off season, then we train almost 5-6 days a week. So that is our schedule right now. Right now we are training 6 days a week and taking off for a day. But when we travel or when we go out of Chennai,
during the season, it reduces.
Correct. You may not have that much time to, you know,
train. We train differently during the off season and during the season. So.
So Ashwin, Chris is saying that Inder has 6 packs and Upper has 3. I don't know whether it is true or
Ashwin
not.
Ashwin just wants to have fun. So
yeah.
I know. I know. So let us go on to two of your batsmen. So have you ever had opportunities where you had to talk to each other to rectify your batting techniques?
We talk a lot, actually. We talk a lot of cricket at home, even during the game, even when we both are batting inside. We help each other because we know each other's game well. So it is easy for us to communicate and spot each other's mistakes, if there is any. And I think we'll be very honest with each other because not many people can tell us straightforward, like, this is the mistake you're doing, this is what you have to do. But between us, I don't think we don't have any hesitation or restrictions between us. So it is like an open conversation between us. If I feel something is not right, or I can directly tell him, so I don't have to be hesitant, actually.
Have you ever got angry at each other during a match?
Not really.
Not
but,
too much, yeah. But
emotions do come out. Yeah. During we're quite intense, but we're competitive. So, but we don't get angry, but we are intense.
Yeah. Oh, great. So let us, I mean, I know Inder, I met you at Bangalore when you were doing a rehab, right, after your injury. And I think you still had that injury. And I think it was only late in the season of last Ranji Trophy that you started getting back, right?
Yeah.
So how was that injury and how do cricketers deal with an injury?
For any sports person and coming from an injury, it's very difficult because you miss a lot of games and the rehab phase is very difficult, actually, to go through that phase. Sitting at home watching cricket is difficult, actually. We are used to playing cricket, so it is difficult to sit at home and do nothing. So that phase is very difficult. The pain is not too much, but still the process itself is actually hard. But you learn a lot of things in that phase as well.
So when you actually come back after this layoff, after the rehab, is it possible for you? I mean, did you actually start striking the ball at the middle of the bat? Did you do things naturally, or there was a learning phase after that?
It takes a bit of time, actually. First couple of months, you have to get into the groove because you're out of the game for a very long time. You've been doing your rehab. Yes, you've been working on your fitness, but the skill part comes in a bit late. At the end of the last couple of months, when you get back to cricket, the last couple of months, you practice your skill, but so it takes time to get into the groove.
Right. So let us, I mean, Ashwin is still with us. But let me talk about Tamil Nadu cricket, right? I mean, both of you are from Tamil Nadu. I think some of the people who are listening to us is also from Tamil Nadu. I think after 1987, that is probably before you were born, right? That was a time when Tamil Nadu won the Ranji Trophy. So it still has been a long, long period. So what's, I mean, Tamil Nadu was always a place where you have given test cricketers, one-day cricketers to the Indian team, but somehow the Ranji Trophy has been eluding you. So what's happening?
See, it is difficult to pinpoint just one thing, but definitely we have the potential. We have won the Vijay Hazare 5 times, so why not the Ranji Trophy? If we put in the hard, like, if we work correctly, if we do the right things, definitely we can win. But it is a process. It will take some time. But I feel if we do the right things in the coming years, we'll be able to get one Ranji Trophy for sure. If not more.
In there any difference of opinion? Because now I need to ask both of you so that I get something out of you both.
No, what Upper said only, as you said, there are a lot of international cricketers right now who are playing for Tamil Nadu.
close to 4 to 5 Tamil Nadu cricketers are playing for the Indian team. So we have the potential to do things. As he said, the shorter format, we have won 5 tournaments. So why not the Ranji Trophy? As he said, we have to do the right things. It's a process. It's a long process. Maybe in a couple of years, we will be able to.
So do you also feel, both of you, that nowadays you have more competition than what it used to be 20, 30 years back? Because now, even a side like Kerala, for example, even a side like Vidarbha, Saurashtra, they're all up there in the semi-finals, finals, etc. So do you feel that now competition is coming from everywhere in the country?
Definitely. You can't take any team lightly these days. There are no easy teams now. You can't take any team lightly. There are almost 30 states and all the states are good enough to play at the higher level and get the trophy.
I think the first three groups, A, B, C, all three are competitive. I think every year there are the top 8 teams are different. It is not like the top 8 teams are almost similar every year. It is different every year. So that tells you the level of the standards has improved nowadays. And at the same time, as you said, there are a lot more teams who are giving more competition to the others.
Sure. So I know as a family, I mean, your parents have played a great role in where you are now. I believe they're doctors, right?
Yes.
So how difficult was it for you to take a decision to get into cricket? I mean, you also leave behind a little bit of academics out there, right? I mean, you don't pursue that. You make a choice. So what was the process like? And how did you take the decision?
It was not very difficult.
Yeah, didn't do academics or anything like that. Right from a very young age, my dad was very passionate about cricket. So there's no problem at home. And at one point, they were like, studies are not very important for you, because they knew that we were into cricket and we were very passionate about cricket. So we wanted to make a career in cricket itself. So they were very supportive. And I think at one point, they understood that. And academics was like secondary for us after 6th, 7th grade. So they were very supportive. There was no pressure at home.
So would you advise people now who are listening to this, who are youngsters, to make a choice between sports and academics, or to take it both together or concentrate on one?
Definitely, they have to take both together. At one point, they'll get to know that which is more important for them or which is working for them. At that stage, they can take a decision, because you can't take a decision at a very young age also. But you will get to know at one point. Instinctively, you will know that. So you have to do both until then, and then wait for the right moment and take one path.
Oh, great. So let us talk a little bit about the IPL. I know you are, both of you have had, I think Upper has had opportunities to almost knock at the doors of the IPL. So how is IPL different, and how was the period like when you were looking at IPL?
I think it was a very, I learned a lot in those 5 years, though I couldn't play, but I wanted to interact with a lot of legends like Dhoni, Hassi, Raina, all those players. But it was a dream come true for me. And though I didn't talk much with them, I observed a lot. I'm not a very talkative person, but I observed a lot. I learned a lot from them, the way they prepared. And when I came back from the IPL, I learned a lot of things, right from preparation, mindset, fitness preparation, all those things, small things, even some. See, when you see from outside also, you can gain a lot of things. You can learn a lot of things right from field sets, how MS Dhoni sets a field for a certain kind of batsman. All those things I watched and learned.
Correct. I mean, amazing. So, Inder and Upper, I just wanted to talk to you about a few of your cricketers that you're close to. Are there any cricketers that you closely interact with, who you think you have played a lot of cricket with, get along well? Who are those cricketers? Who would that be?
We have a lot of friends actually, but most of the friends are from the cricketing side only. Right from Dinesh Karthik from the Tamil Nadu team, Dinesh Karthik, Abhinav Mukund, Malol and Ashwin Krist. There are a lot of friends in the cricketing fraternity. So we interact with them a lot. On the field, off the field, we spend a lot of time with them.
So, typically I ask this question to people. See, every state has a few people who represent the country and then get back for some of the games. So, you have a few of them in your own team, right? In Tamil Nadu team. So are there things that you learn from them? What are the things that probably you look up to them or learn from them, or while interacting, while playing together? Are there any points which you would like to share to the viewers?
Like from seniors from our state, is it?
From seniors, yeah. From seniors, yeah. People who have played for the state, etc. Play for the country.
So you learn a lot from all the seniors, not only from the Tamil Nadu side, anywhere. I think when I went into the Ranji Trophy team, the most important thing was work ethics. I think the way they prepared. When I was very young, I used to practice, but not with so much purpose or quality. Mm-hmm. So once I went into the Ranji Trophy team, I saw a lot of these legends, like the way Dinesh Karthik practiced or an Ashwin practiced. So all those cricketers who played for the country. And the way they practiced with the purpose they had when they came in for each session was amazing. So that was the kind of thing I wanted to inculcate into my thing as well.
Mm-hmm. So talking about Dinesh Karthik, is the story of Dinesh Karthik's bat being used in the 2012 final, is that a story or is it a reality?
No, it happened actually. It was an incident. I think he gave me a bat before the World Cup. So I carried 3 bats to the World Cup and I didn't use it till the semi-final. So what happened was Unmukt was batting and he said, I think he broke his bat. His bat broke and he wanted another bat and my bat was, Dinesh Karthik's bat was like suiting him. It worked for him. So he was, he said, okay, I'll play with this bat. And he did reasonably well in the semi-finals. So he went on to play with the same bat on, I think during the finals as well. And he got 100 and as you know, it was a memorable innings for all of us and for him.
The bat still stays with him, still is with him? Or
it is with him now.
Okay. So let us get on to the last session where I want to ask you a few quick questions. Let's see how well it can be answered. Who is a better bowler between the both?
Upper.
Is that true, Upper?
I don't know because Indar has stopped bowling for now because of his shoulder. He'll start bowling soon. But for now, I've been bowling a lot.
It's easier for me to answer this question.
Test, one day years or T20?
Test, obviously test.
Yeah, test. That's the real challenge.
Anyone who I talk to on the cricketing side, they all say test is ultimate. They all want to be a test player. Right?
It is a challenge.
Okay, so that's great. Is there anyone in the Indian team that you frequently talk to?
Frequently talk to from the Indian team? I don't think so because...
Okay.
Not really.
That's fine. What's your favorite batting shot? I mean, both of you can take a shot at it.
I like the flick shot. I like to cover drive a lot. So, drives any drive, but cover drive.
But is there even a flick shot these days? I don't see in T20 flick shots being used as much. Is it still a shot in your dictionary these days?
Definitely. Yeah. On the onside, there's always a flick shot. So I like playing the flick shots, I think.
Do you guys sledge on the field?
Not really, not much. Yeah. We're very intense on the field, but not
competitive intense.
Yeah. We play not the sport to the extent of sledging. We don't sledge.
The favorite fielding positions for both
slips.
Slips. So if there's only one slip, who goes there?
I think mostly Inder. Yeah, I go there awfully.
Because is it because he probably ends up being the captain and more of
not really, but over the years because of the shoulder issue, it's better for me to stand and slip. So that is the reason why if there is a slip and if you have to choose, then I go there.
Yeah. I got it. Any favorite cricketer that you have? I mean, you have talked about a few of them, but is there any favorite cricketer that you both look up to over the generations?
Let's see, there are a lot of cricketers, but right now it's
MS Dhoni a lot.
Yeah. So.
Okay. I mean, that's great. So we have come to the conclusion of that talk, and Ankit is saying that they compulsorily keep 2 slips. But talking about Ankit. But Ankit and all of you, you also play for the same squad in Chennai, right? Currently, Jolly Rovers. So talk a little bit about the squad and how Chennai cricket is important for cricketers from different places. I think Samit plays for that player, Smit Patel plays for that squad. You have, I think, Murali Vijay who probably plays for that. So how is a Chennai cricket like?
See, it is very important for all of us to play because we need match practice, and it is just before the Ranji Trophy season, before the domestic season. So it is not only good for us, as you said, Ankit plays here, Smith plays here, a lot of cricketers play here, and it is like a preparatory tournament before the domestic season. So we take it very seriously, and the competition here is very high also. And as you said, a proper preparation before the domestic season is very important. So first division gives us the opportunity to play 6-7 proper 3-day games or 2-day games before the season.
So I was talking to Ankit, in fact, on Monday, and he was also telling that Chennai cricket, there is a lot of importance because you get to learn a lot of things there. Even K.S. Bharat was talking about the same thing. So when you play for the Chennai League, do you jostle for going up the batting order that you want to play on number one, number two down, or?
See, if Ankit is batting, then we won't get a chance to bat.
Yeah. He bats with the way back, right?
He did that once, as upper goes before Ankit, but I go after Ankit most probably, so it's very difficult to get a chance. So we try and rotate at times because it's very difficult to get a chance. Ankit is batting.
and what language do you guys speak? Because I know that you have people from different parts of the country speak playing there. So what language do you use?
Amongst us, we speak English, Tamil, but when you interact, I know a little bit of Hindi, so with whatever Hindi I know, I can interact a little bit. So,
when Ankit is there,
most of them know English, because we'll also learn a bit. See, all of us know English, so Hindi is just for us to improve, that's all.
Sure. So, if I last few questions, both of you, what is your, who is the fastest bowler, most difficult bowler that you have faced? In India or outside India?
In India, I think when I was playing Ranji Trophy 3-4 years back, Bumrah was there. We were playing against Gujarat, so I found it difficult to play him. It was really quick at that point of time. I think Bumrah is really quick, and I think I played Lockie Ferguson when I was in Pune, so he was really quick. He bowled more, I think, above 145. So he was one of the fastest bowlers I've faced.
So we've run, we have almost ended the session. I think we can keep on talking, but I think it's great to have had this small session with you. I hope the cricketing season starts soon, and both of you have the opportunity to get back onto the field. Any timelines? When do you think cricket can be back?
It is very difficult to predict right now, but hopefully soon, once things settle down, but I don't think in Chennai right now it's not settling down, so it is only going up. So once things settle down, then
hopefully in a couple of months or something like that.
So have you actually taken the bat out and done a few knocks?
Yeah, we have started
knocking
at home itself.
Yeah,
so we are doing some drills at home. Nothing serious as such, but once things settle down and then the ground reopens, then we'll start batting properly.
Thanks, both Upper and Inder. Thank you very much from the entire Fast Enough family. You have been a great support for all of us. We would also like to thank all the viewers who have been here listening to you. We had a wonderful time talking to you, and I'm hoping that we'll get to see you both soon, and hopefully march towards the journey of making to the Indian team and see you there.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Vijay.
Thanks a lot.
Yeah, thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Vijay. Thank you.